have a personal finance episode for you today. Hi, this is Shop Talk. I'm Lexi Schulze, sitting in for Ria Tanhuatco Trilio. Personal planners who have been on the show will always talk about the stock market as one of the investment instruments to consider. But how does one actually start investing in equities? Well, we'll find out today as we talk about basic stock trading steps. And here to tell us more about it is Jay Peñaflor. He's the assistant head at the Market Education Department of the Philippine Stock Exchange. Hi, Jay.
Hi, Lexi.
Thanks for coming to the show.
No problem. No problem. Anytime.
And I hear that today was a very busy day for the market because it reached an all-time high.
Exactly.
Ever.
So the market index, the PSCI, went up significantly today, all-time high. So this is the best time to invest.
But it must have been crazy busy for you this morning.
Exactly. Busy educating the Filipinos on how they can invest and hopefully win in stocks.
Okay, well, let's do stock market 101 today.
Yeah.
Of course, the first thing, because usually in a class to educate, you go with definitions.
Exactly.
So let's talk about a stock. What exactly is a stock?
Lexi, let me start by saying that stock is a good investment.
Okay.
It is something that you can buy or you can invest into with the expectation that it will give you a return well as the time goes by.
Okay.
It is an equity security, which means that it is an ownership interest in a company.
Okay.
Which means that if you buy shares or stocks of a specific company, you become a stockholder or simply an owner of the company.
Right. Let's go with examples, let's say.
Exactly.
Let's say I want to go in there and give me an example of a company that I can own stocks of.
Okay. ABS-CBN is listed. Its shares are being sold to the investing public through the stock market. So if you want to buy, if you are an investor or if you bought 100 shares of ABS-CBN, then you are one of its stockholders or you are considered one of its co-owners.
Right. Well, 100 shares sounds so big for a first-timer.
Yeah.
But before we go to that, let me ask you, why are Filipinos not very, I guess, invested in stocks?
Exactly.
We have some, or maybe the businessmen or, you know, who are onto it and know their stuff very well, but why the basic Filipino?
Well,
why not?
We found out that there are two reasons, Lexi, why Filipinos are not into stock investing.
Mm-hmm.
Well, the first reason is that, it's related to economics or economic related. Most Filipinos do not have disposable income which they can use to invest in stocks.
Right.
But we found out that one of the main culprits also is a lack of awareness level. We do not know how to go about it.
Right.
Well, most Filipinos think that stock investing is complex, very hard to understand.
Oh, and sometimes I guess you can not equate it to gambling, but diba, with gambling, people have money to burn. They'll go in, like let's say with 2,500 or 10,000, and they're willing to lose it.
Exactly. And, you're right, there are Filipinos who have the capacity or the disposable income which they can use to invest in stocks. So we really need to educate. We really have to tell them that stocks can be a very good alternative investment instrument for Filipinos.
Because we do have a lot of also insurances, and Filipinos like buying life insurance, health insurance. Well, stocks is also a good option for them if they do have
Most
money.
Filipinos are into fixed income instruments.
Sigurista.
Like, yeah, exactly. most of us, I think most people in this studio have bank deposits. Most of us are risk averse, you know?
Correct.
We're afraid to lose our money.
So this is putting money in the bank, simple as that.
Yeah,
because you know it's there, it's not going to disappear.
And it earns 1-3% a year.
But
so
not very much.
Not very much.
Okay.
Not very much.
So now let's talk about the advantages, obviously, of stocks.
Yeah.
Let's go into that.
Okay.
So we have unlimited returns.
Yeah. First is, stocks offers unlimited returns.
Right.
Okay. There are stocks which can increase up to 50% of their present values in just one day or maybe less.
In a day?
In a day. Yeah, that's
wow,
right.
Wow, 50%.
Yeah, 50% in a day or maybe higher in just 1 week. And there are no other investment instruments which can match the return or the multiplier that you can get from stocks.
Right.
But, there is an investment concept which says that the higher the return, the higher the risk.
Always.
Always. Yeah, so you can earn as much as 50% in just one day in stocks, but if you invest without the right knowledge or the right discipline, the possibility of losing by as much as 50% is also highly possible.
Well, that's why you have a stockbroker, isn't
exactly.
it? Because you want to know that you have somebody who knows the stock, who
and
can read
why
the stocks
very PSE
well.
Is here. That's
right,
why
exactly.
our department is here, because we want to teach the Filipinos on how they can invest wisely
mm-hmm.
by minimizing the returns, and hopefully by doing that they can maximize their profits from their stock investments.
And when you talk about profits, you're also talking about dividends and capital gain.
Exactly.
So can you tell me the difference between the two? Do each of, like, let's say SMC or any ABS-CBN, do they give you both?
Yeah, some companies give both.
Okay.
Okay. We said a while ago that as one of the owners of the company, you are entitled to receive economic benefits.
Okay.
You are entitled to share on whatever profit that the company will generate. And your share on the company's profit will be in the form of dividends, or to be more specific, cash divs.
Okay.
Which most or some companies declare or give on an annual basis.
Okay, so it's yearly.
Yearly.
So kinukumpul nila, tapos you get one fee at
tama.
The end of the year.
Yeah, tama.
Okay.
And let me tell you, Alexi, that there are companies whose dividend or whose cash dividend is even higher than the yield that you can get from fixed income instruments like savings and time deposit.
Right.
There are companies,
and
I
this
know,
is 1 year.
1 year, uh-uh. Yeah. There are companies I know, like, I'm not sure if I'm allowed to mention companies, but well, there are companies whose annual dividend yield is from 8 to 10%. That is significantly
wow.
higher than what you can get from your time deposit.
Because banks are what, 3 to 5%.
Time deposit, 2 to 3%, or maybe less.
Low pa nga.
Yeah.
And capital gains. What exactly is capital gains?
Okay, capital gains is simply the difference between a stock's selling mm-hmm. and purchasing values. There is only one important rule in stocks that beginners must always remember.
Okay, this is what I have to hear.
Yeah, buy low and then sell high.
Okay.
So let's say, for example, you bought at 1 peso and then set your return goal. When investing in stocks, always set your return goal. I'll buy this at 1 peso and sell as soon as it hits 50%, for example.
Mm-hmm.
So buy low and then sell at 150 or 1 peso and 50 centavos per share. By doing that, you'll get 50%.
Well, that's common sense, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. So we're talking about the advantages of stocks. It's also very liquid.
Very liquid.
Mm-hmm.
You can sell your stocks anytime you want to. You can buy today, or you can buy at 10 a.m. today, and then maybe sell it at 11 a.m. as soon as its price increases. Or maybe buy today and mm-hmm. then sell after 3 days.
As opposed to a time deposit, I suppose.
Exactly.
Okay.
But the question is, if I sell today or after 3 days, when will I get my
your money
proceeds?
Back. Oh, correct.
Yeah. Then we have what we call the T+3 settlement period.
Okay.
Let us say, for example, you sell today or mm-hmm. you sold today, so you will have to count 3 days, 3 trading days. Tomorrow is Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. On Thursday, you'll get the check from your broker.
Wow. Yeah. And of course, we also have tax advantage and minimal investment.
Yeah. Let me ask you, Lexi, how much do you think is your interest income tax from banks? I think 20%.
Okay.
Right? 20%, which means that if you earned,
yes,
or if your total interest income from a universal bank is 1,000 pesos, for example, after 1 year. So you will not get everything. 20% interest income tax will be deducted from the 1,000.
Right.
So you will get 800 pesos.
As
minus
opposed
some
to
other
charges. Extra
charges
pa yan.
Processing,
but with stocks?
With stocks, only 0.5%. No capital gain stocks. 0.5% is what we call the stock transaction tax, which is being imposed every time an investor sells his stocks. So 0.5% versus 10%.
Correct.
That is what you call
tax
advantage.
That's a big difference.
Exactly.
That's a big difference. And of course, minimal investment.
Minimal investment. Mm-hmm. Most Filipinos think that you need hundreds of thousands of pesos to invest in stocks. Well, that is not true.
So what would be your, like, let's say, if I were to invest tomorrow, what would be a nice round number for it?
Well, you can invest for as low as 5,000 pesos.
You see? So it's not bad. So people have that money.
Exactly.
Instead of using it for other things.
For other things.
But okay, so we have so many things to talk about. Let's talk about the risk and reward of different investment instruments.
Okay.
We've already talked about deposits.
Yeah.
Okay, so obviously the liquidity, it's easily withdrawable. You can.
Yeah, you can withdraw anytime you want to from automated teller machines.
Right.
Or just by going to your bank, you know.
And so walang risk siya.
No risk,
super
fixed.
Low risk.
Yeah.
Oh.
1% to 2% per year. But, no risk, but very limited return.
So it's really like that. It's inversely proportional. When the risk is low, the reward is also, I know, it's proportional.
Exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
So, okay, so we also have, treasury bills.
Treasury bills is also another type of a fixed income instrument. Well, a little higher than your bank or savings deposit, 2 to 3%, I think, but still very, very low.
Mm-hmm.
Not even higher than the...
very safe pa rin.
Very
pero quite
safe pa rin.
Low.
Quite low. No, not even higher than the prevailing inflation rate. Lexi, when you invest, always ensure that your annual yield or that your total returns should always be higher than the prevailing inflation rate. So before investing, you should ask yourself, what is the inflation rate?
Okay.
Or what is the prevailing inflation rate? Or maybe you can ask your bank teller or maybe the bank manager. You know, because, the Philippine inflation rate at the moment is 4.6%.
Okay, well, we'll talk more numbers because we will also look at the risk and reward of stocks when we come back. We'll talk about investment procedures after this. Keep it here. Shop Talk will be right back.